I decided to take TV because I was very interested in making small film type productions with my home camcorder. And when I heard the chance, when I heard about the chance to use real professional equipment to do some things that I like to do, I jumped on it, and that's how I ended up in TV.
Well, my friend Bill, he was doing it last year, and he had a lot of fun. And I came down, and I saw how some of the things were done, and I was really interested in that.
Did it taught me a lot more about just TV. It taught me more about dealing with people.
Alone. Alone.
Thank you. Next word for Peter is arithmetic. One of my favorite subjects is arithmetic, where you work with numbers.
Arithmetic. ARITHEM. ARITHMETIC.
Judges.
Arithmetic.
April, that's fourth month and 29th day. So that's today's day. You write this way up and down.
Sounds of hissing steam and squeaking metal. I looked through my window and saw a train standing perfectly still in front of my house. It was wrapped in an apron of steam.
And as I've explained in the past, this started as a science fair. It now is an all-school fair. Roughly 20 years, Dr. Mayo?
20 years.
Roughly 20 years, 20 years. We've had it as an all-school fair.
I've done social studies reports, I've done contests, I've done PSAs. I've done editing projects, tons of stuff.
I did a interview with Ed Gaff, the janitor. That was like one of the first projects I've ever done.
And we have plants here where little kids can plant them.
About the organ donation, we have pamphlets here that people can sign up and be one. We're selling bumper stickers and also signing a petition to try and get a stamp put into circulation to help raise people's awareness.
Senator, thank you very much for a wonderful job.
We have three pieces. The first one is a jazz waltz entitled Sailing, and this is going to feature senior Tim McGinley on the flugelhorn and sophomore Tom Grace on the drums. This is called Sailing.
Yeah, we get the tabletop too.
Tabletop.
Ah, oh, that's beautiful. Oh, beautiful. Ooh. You get the table.
Looks pretty sturdy.
John D'Ambrosio, another football player, and Patricia Radigan. Give her a big hand. There we go. Looking good.
They can
have money for research and for education purposes and anything else that they need money for. To become a National Honor Society member, you must have a grade point average of 3.4.
I expect the work to be, it is hard work, because you have to do the script, the storyboard, you have to get like all of our footage together before you can even edit. You have to do a lot of work. It's really hard work, too. It isn't like something you throw together in like 2 seconds. Like a 5-minute piece might take as long as a month to complete.
Not always true. It's something that you have to work at. It's not just you're not born with the creativity to produce television. It's something that you have to work at and become better at. And I learned that you can't just go out there and try to produce something without having the teaching and the background information to do any of that. So I thought when I got down here my first few days that I was going to be really incredible at TV, but Jude taught us a lot about television, and there's a lot more involved, and I found that I wasn't as good as I thought I was going to be. However, I am improving.
It's a lot more work than I thought, but it goes along pretty easily.
A lot of variety shows and things like that. I really wasn't a troublemaker. I got in a lot of trouble because I never knew when to stop talking. That still happens today. I love the school.
In the old days, before mail was carried in fancy dancy mail trucks by men in fancy dancy uniform,
he prepares you for the future.
He teaches it a lot about life.
It's like more professional though. It's not like other high school groups or anything.
I've done close to maybe 30, 35 shows as an actor. It's a chance for people to express themselves, to try to emote.
Has that ever happened to you? That's why every morning before I go to work, I eat my butts. Butt cereal gives me what I need to get up and go in the morning. And it's chock full of nicotine and tar. But not only that, it tastes great too.
I've used the Amiga to do the bulletin board that runs on TV like every night. I like it. I don't know it as well as some other people that have used it in the past, but it's good. I like it.
The Amiga is a computer we use for character generation. It's pretty easy to use because it has Windows, and most of the time when I use it for character generation on programs like the titles and the endings and like the scores, stuff like that.
Welcome to News 15, Wakefield High School's premier news program. I am Pat Kilkelly.
And I'm John Barris. Tonight our top story is an interview with some of the students that have made the show possible.
Tonight our top story is Russ Mezikowski's Earth Day. So everybody enjoy Earth Day.
I think I'm better on the audio aspect than like just like doing cameras and stuff, but I'm pretty well-rounded. I'm a semi-good leader. I'm a good follower. Good at everything, I guess. I'm just so huge.
I want to go on to communications in college, and I wish to pursue that career, I guess you could say. So everything I learned here will help me in college. And this is just like the basics, I guess, but and I'll know the fundamentals of television if I ever go into television.
I plan on going into TV in college and then hopefully after college.
It's fun because everyone has to depend on each other.
The communication process in television is one thing that everyone needs to learn. If you can't express yourself or you can't talk to other people, then you're not really going to get very far in life. So the communications end of television is something that everyone can use later in life. If you really don't know how to use a computer or a camera, and you're not going to get into the field, then it's not that big a deal. But the things that you learn in communication and television are going to be a big part of what you do later in life.